This is ridiculous. How long am I gonna have to wait? Excuse me, miss? May I ask you something?
Oh, are you here to visit a family member? If so, then the entrance is...
No, that's not why I'm here. I have an appointment with Dr. Rousseau, the chief surgeon. But no one's been able to get my message to him.
If that's the case, then let me call for his secretary.
I'm sorry to inconvenience you. Thank you, though. You're a doctor here, aren't you?
Yes, my name is Valerie Blaylock.
Is Professor Wilkins busy? I was hoping I might get a chance to meet him.
Yes. Well, the professor is... He's very busy. I rarely see him myself.
Well, I guess it can't be helped. But I'd still like to meet him someday. Ah, you must be Dr. Rousseau's secretary. Thank you. My name is Irene Quattro. I'm the director of Caduceus.
The organization under the direct control of Health and Human Services?
Thank you very much for your help today. I appreciate it.
Hey, Marcus. It's already been 10 days, and he still hasn't told us about his condition.
I'm sure he hasn't forgotten. He must have his reasons.
He sure is taking his time, considering the trouble he went to bring us back here. Oh, by the way, this morning I met someone that was here to see Rousseau. I was surprised when she introduced herself. Take a guess who she was.
His mistress?
Very funny. Come on, be serious.
I know him better than you do.
Well, it turns out she's the director of Caduceus. She oversees all of the medical research institutions located in the U.S.
She's from Caduceus?
Actually, she seemed more interested in speaking with Professor Wilkins. I wonder how she knows about him. Isn't it strange?
It sounds like trouble, if you ask me.
Dr. Vaughn! Dr. Blaylock! We need you in the OR!
What's the matter, Elena?
3 people were hit by a car. 2 are in critical condition. Dr. Rousseau began treating the one who was in the worst state. But he left to treat a different patient and ordered you two to take the ones in critical condition.
We can't afford to waste any time. His life's in jeopardy.
The patient is Ricardo Garcia, a 35-year-old male. He was in a car accident. He has injuries to the abdomen, including a few broken ribs and a pierced spleen.
This doesn't look good.
In this operation, we have several objectives. We need to treat his lacerations, repair his broken ribs, and attend to his spleen.
This will be a difficult operation. No wonder Rousseau took off so fast.
Well, I'm sure we can handle it.
We've analyzed his blood type and done the necessary screening and cross-matching. We've also got an ample supply of blood on hand. All you need to worry about is the operation.
I'm ready to start the procedure.
Doctor, hurry! The patient's gone into cardiac arrest. We need to use the defibrillator.
All right, we have a pulse.
His spleen's in bad shape, and his vitals are dropping because of massive hemorrhaging.
We'll have to retrieve the bone fragments while treating the injuries and hemorrhages.
We won't be able to suture that big of a wound. We'll have to close it first.
Now pinch one side of the wound. Okay. Now hurry up and suture it. That takes care of the largest wound. But don't forget about the others.
Progress with the bone fragments, but the spleen requires immediate treatment.
Looks like we got all the bone fragments, but we better treat the other wounds before continuing.
Now that we've taken care of the wounds, we can reassemble the bone fragments.
So far, so good. We're almost done. What? But that was the last piece. Don't tell me we missed a fragment.
This isn't good. We'll have to use the defibrillator.
Was that hemorrhagic shock? His spleen was bleeding pretty heavily. Got it? No wonder we missed it. Okay, Doctor. You know what to do. Be sure to keep an eye on his vitals, though. We've got all the pieces now, but please treat his remaining nerves first.
Alright, let's place the last bone fragment.
All the pieces are in place. Let's see how that completes the operation. Please close him up. It was an unexpected operation, but I'm glad it went smoothly. Well done, team.
I see that you are both quite skilled.
I'm sorry, you are?
I'm Irene Quattro from Caduceus. Nice to meet you. I heard there was an emergency, so I changed into my surgical gown. But I see that wasn't necessary.
Valerie, is this the woman you were telling me about?
Thank you, ma'am. It's an honor to receive such praise.
A doctor with a healing touch. It's been a while since I've been surprised like this. If the opportunity arises, I'd like to see it used again.
I'd be glad to show you.
This is an impressive hospital. I hope that we meet again. Please excuse me.
I don't think it was good for her to have seen that.
What do you mean, Marcus?
Thank you. Thank you so much, Doctor. We were told he wouldn't make it, but you saved him.
I just did my best, Mrs. Garcia. Considering his injuries, it's a miracle he survived. He must have an angel looking over his shoulder.
I don't know how we'll ever repay you. Thank you so much.
There's no need for tears. Now, let's discuss his future treatment options.
Oh, as long as he's in your hands, Dr. Russo, I know he'll be okay.
Oh, it's you, Vaughn.
Marcus, he's...
It's not worth getting upset over. The patient is all right. That's all that matters. Professor Wilkins has asked to see us, so we'd better get going.
I suppose you're right.
Dr. Russo, is something wrong?
Oh, no, it's nothing. Please come with me, Mrs. Garcia. Let's go see how your husband is faring.
So, I heard that Russo took credit for everything. You must be disappointed.
I'm just glad the patient's okay.
He's an excellent doctor, although rather shrewd at times. And I would never trust him to operate on me. That's why I summoned you here, Marcus. You have a rare talent.
I didn't want to come back.
I'm aware of that. Regardless, we'll meet tomorrow to discuss my operation. The procedure is scheduled for 4 days from now. I'll leave you to choose your team.
Okay.